Picking the right case for your PC components is so much more important than most people think. Hey, what's going on YouTube? Danny here with Danny's Tech Channel. If you can't tell already by the layout of my table, today I want to talk about cases. As I said in the intro, cases are really an important part of building your own custom PC. In my eyes, the case should be the very first thing that you pick. Your entire build revolves around the case. If you buy a case that's too small, your components might not fit in it. If you buy a case that's too large, your case may look empty inside if you put small components in there. So let's take a look at a few things to think about when shopping for your next case. First thing that I think you should be looking at is the features of the case. Some of the things that stand out to me that are important when I'm shopping for a case are your front I/O. If it doesn't have enough ports for what I want to do, you may not be wanting to reach behind the case every time you want to plug something into the back of your motherboard. So what I look for is USB-A's, even USB-C's now, and then headphone jack, power and reset buttons. That's right, some cases don't have reset buttons. And for me, that's something that I really enjoy having, especially if I'm going to be doing any kind of overclocking, I could just hit the reset button real quick on top of the case. And then some cases also have RGB control buttons. If you have RGB fans you're putting in your case and you don't have RGB headers on your motherboard, you'll need a controller built into your case that can handle that type of stuff. Another thing is water cooling support. That's a cool feature that some people want to be able to do in the future. A small case that doesn't have water cooling support isn't going to be a viable option for an upgrade for you later. Some people want to mount their GPUs vertically as well. If you want to get a case that has that option for later on, you can vertically mount your GPU as long as your case can allow it. Another thing I look for is the ease of disassembly. Does it have quick release panels that I can pop off or magnetic dust filters or anything for cleaning later on? I love having these removable top magnetic dust filters so that I can spray them out with a can of air or something and then just pop them back onto the case. Finally, the last feature that's really important to me is the space for all your components. Like I said at the beginning, if you buy a case that's too small, it won't have the space for your components. So make sure you pay attention to that when you're buying. Speaking of space, the second major topic to look out for is size. I know I said it at the beginning and I keep harping on it. Bigger cases gives you more room to be able to work with and then more space for bigger components. Graphics cards are getting much larger these days and you need a case that can fit that type of stuff. Another aspect of the space feature is your cable management space. If you open the back of any of these cases, you'll see clearance for your cable management routing and then the channels and everything that cable management can do as well. If you don't have adequate space for your cable management, you're gonna be shoving and trying to slam closed this back panel. If this is your first time building a computer, I would get something like these bigger cases on the right rather than my smaller cases I have on the left here. The smaller the case, the harder it is to build in. Now, on the flip side of that, the smaller case takes up a smaller footprint. So if you're gonna have limited room on your desk or maybe under your desk or something, a smaller case like one of these may be the better bet for you. But like I said, it gives you less room to work with. And then temperatures are also something to worry about. A smaller case usually has all your components crammed together and that creates higher temperatures when you're running games or workloads or anything like that. If you're getting value out of today's video, don't forget to hit like down below for me so that YouTube's algorithm knows that I'm doing a good job. Next thing I want to talk about is airflow. To me, airflow is one of the most important parts of picking your case for your computer. If you buy a case like the one I have over here, the NZXT H510 Elite, the front of it is glass. That has almost no airflow. I actually have a small ventilated panel, as you can see on the backside here. That's all the airflow coming into the case. And then on the top of it, it only has one 140 mil exhaust. Now, something like this Cooler Master MB311L has a mesh front panel, an entire mesh top to it. It does have tempered glass on the side, but your airflow pattern is really good as far as having a mesh front and mesh top. Now, the downside of mesh is that you have a lot more dust accumulation because the less airflow restriction you have, the more stuff can flow in. So obviously dust is gonna get in there and you'll have to take it apart and kind of clean it more often than you would with a more restricted case. Tempered glass is the biggest fad in computers right now. Some people don't like it, some people do. Tempered glass looks great on the case, but it restricts airflow as well. Like I said, with the NZXT case I have here, the tempered glass on the front looks awesome to be able to show off the RGB and the ring fans and everything, but it restricts airflow. Glass is an insulator. It will not allow heat to escape, and it obviously doesn't allow air to flow through it. Another part of airflow is the fans that are included with the case. The Cooler Master case I have here has two front fans to be able to allow airflow. This Corsair case has three fans and they're RGB. So that's another plus, I guess, when you're looking for a case, is you don't have to buy extra fans. Speaking of saving money by having the fans already included in the case, price versus components is very important in buying a case. You don't want to spend $3,000 on components on super high-end hardware and a crazy over-the-top build and buy a $30 case. The airflow is usually not the best on those price cases. You just want to make it match what you're spending on the computer too. Now, in the flip-flop of that, don't spend $300 on a case and $50 on the components, because you could have spent that money elsewhere on a better CPU or a better GPU maybe, and then kind of cut it down on the case a little bit. Now, with increase in price comes increase in workmanship and everything. Usually when you're paying higher prices for cases, it will give you other accessories and stuff. Like I said, some of these cases come with RGB fans included, so that's a plus in the cost category. When you're raising your price of your case, those types of things will be included. Now, cheap doesn't necessarily mean cheap. I'm gonna use the NZXT H1 as an example right now. If you don't already know what's going on, there's an issue with the H1 case that the riser cable has been known to create a grounding issue, and they've had a few instances where the cases have caught fire. So they're working on this issue. They already stopped selling this, actually. You can't buy these right now, but that's an example of quality control. This case is $350 USD. Now, it comes with a power supply and a liquid cooler and all kinds of stuff, but obviously it's a more premium, high-end priced case, and it still has issues with quality control. But I've also bought cases that cost me $30 and $40 that turned out to be really good cases. Now, they don't have the best cable management, they didn't have the most amazing airflow, and they didn't include fans with it. But I mean, for $30, you gotta expect what you're paying for. I wanted to explain that both ends of the spectrum, a high-end case doesn't necessarily mean that it's high quality. You have to do your research ahead of time on the specific case you're looking for. At the end of the day, what really matters and the most important bullet point for me is, does it look good to you? If you don't enjoy looking at the thing, then it really doesn't matter what you purchase. A good amount of people that take the time to build a custom PC, I think, are gonna agree with me, that want the tempered glass, that wanna show off the build, show off your workmanship that you've done on it, and they'll sit it on top of their desk. And that's why I said the case to me is the most important thing when you're purchasing your PC, because that's what you see. So if the style of the case, the theme that you wanna go with, the more I get into PC building, I wanna do like build themes and stuff like that. If you haven't checked out my Cyberpunk build, I'll leave a link down in the description. You can take a look at that. I'm really happy with how the retro design looked. But anyways, those are some things that you can look at when you're picking your case. And as long as it comes within your budget, you've made a good choice. You just want it to fit your components, look good on your desk, and come in at a decent price. Now, if you have any more questions about PCs or PC-related content, you can check out any of my other videos, or you can message me on Twitter at DannysTechYT. I always post up what videos are gonna be going live and what videos I'm working on over on Twitter, so it's a little way to take a closer look at Danny's Tech Channel than just YouTube. And as I say in every single video, I'm Danny with Danny's Tech Channel, and I'll see you in the next one. Most people that take the time to cheap doesn't mean cheap. Cheap, 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 cheap. The H500, H510 Elite.